one president, 36 governors, all the law, state lawmakers, federal lawmakers, every single political office in this country occupied by true representative of the people. Or at least a majority of it. You know? That is the first step. So our first step here is power. Let's discuss. Are we looking for violent change? And are we ready? Or if we're in a military democracy, I would understand if we have to use violent tactics. But if our oppressors, because that is how oppression works, the oppressor must lose their grip to get it by that grip. So in the way of losing their grip, they gave us democracy to tighten their grip on corruption and their manipulation and complete ownership, state capture in the name of democracy. So if we have this opening called democracy, why can't we organize as the people? Organize ourselves. And I will tell you why. It is not because the Nigerian youths are watching BBN or the Nigerian youths are lazy. It is because the Nigerian professional doesn't want to organize. The Nigerian youths cannot change Nigeria. I will say it all day. Youths are nothing but a reflection of society. You want to know whether your society is crazy? Look at your youths. If you want to know whether your society is intelligent, look at your youths. Youths are only a reflection of society. Youths have no power. They have no money. No jobs. How do they begin to bring influence on society? It is the professionals that must organize the platform to bring them in with the ideas and channel their energy correctly. There is no nation, I've never seen a nation that was built by young people. Show me the nation that is thriving in the world today that was built by a couple of 20-year-olds or 30-year-olds. Let's build a nation. No, nations are built by the experience of the old and the energy of the young. This our elitist narrative spread by their media, who are also professionals. So I tell you, it is the Nigerian professional letting the people down at every juncture of this country's history. So my sit down here today and talk about, people are scared because of ELSAs. Who started calling young people hoodlums? Is it not the media? You see people fighting for their rights, you're sitting down and say, because they loot one shop. What is the value of one African life? One building? Two buildings? No, I'm asking because I really want to know, because throughout the ELSAs, you really made me see the true picture, the heart of the Nigerian professional. Not just the media. They called bankers, they called politicians, everybody calling the young people hoodlums, we can accept this looting. The same looting that they have been looting since before these young people were born was suddenly something nobody has seen before. Hey! Looting! They are looting! Baba, I don't know what's going inside your mood, you never drop up. Anyway, let me not go there too much. But I realized immediately, because we are also infected by the spirit of our slave trading leaders, this spirit of slave traders that are ruling you and their ancestors and their descendants and their agents, you are also infected by their spirit. So you can sit down in your house comfortably, then go to work comfortably, knowing every day in the back of your mind that thousands of Nigerian children are dying in hospitals. Forget school. If you don't go to school, to me, that's really a disadvantage. All this knows about education. What am I going to learn today? I finished school. What did I learn today? There's nothing I learned in school that I'm doing today in my life. When last did you find X of your life? When the simultaneous equation, when was the last time simultaneous equation help you solve your girlfriend's problem? Listen, what we must understand is knowledge. Knowledge does not come from education. In fact, education... indoctrination to give you the spirit of the elite. Because the elite designed the education. So that's why they give it to you to behave like them. That's why young people in Nigeria are criminals. Because our elites are criminals. It is a reflection direct. And you have gone to school, right? You have gone to school only for them to justify that behavior. Finish. So when I see NSAS protest, I will say, oh, we did not organize. No. NSAS. What does it mean? If the NSAS, what does it change in your life if you don't have pens? You must also understand the elitist nature of NSAS. The reason why so many of your professionals and favorite artists join NSAS, I will tell you, it's not because they care that police is beating you. Your favorite artist, if he's coming here, he will bring police. Amobo with Koboko, ready to whip you if you hear him too much. So don't think he's against police brutality for standing there. He's standing there because SARS are the only police department that disturb boys that have some money. So when they are PA, when they don't buy pens or they go out, SARS go arrest them. How would they call them? Oh, SARS hold me. Oh, this SARS safe. Because that's why we're telling you to end SARS. Because this is how the Nigerian professionals engage with the Nigerian system. Now, where it concerns them, they know. So your children can be dying in hospital. So far, they have private hospital. They don't give a fuck. Your children can stay at home uneducated, going to substandard school for the rest of your life. The Nigerian professional will not care. They've provided private school. You understand? The road in your neighborhood might be dilapidated. Transportation system crumble. He has jeep and driver. You understand their psyche? It is this lack of camaraderie, solidarity with the few in Nigeria, in Africa as a whole, that have been able to raise our head up a bit, you know, in this oppressive state. We've been made to believe that, yes, that is the all in all. We are now also better than the rest of people that have not made it. So our idea, we start taking dumbass European ideas like entrepreneurship. So okay, so you now take one person. So we are all in this prison. It's a prison. You know, you escape from the prison. Only you escape back. You are outside now. But you don't want to just be outside. And I say, let me help somebody inside. You see, you go back, you help two people. We are 200 million inside this cell, inside this prison. You remove two people. Yes. So, the job is not to keep escaping from the prison. Our duty is to destroy the prison. Completely annihilate it, break it down, probably so that everybody can just be free. You understand? So this is our way, even the NSAS, because those that benefit, the professionals, those that have jobs, that have contracts, that are close, depends on the oppressors, because, you know, the oppressors, to them, we're all animals. Don't doubt it. You are an animal, don't see you as a human being. But from all animals, you know, you have pets, the ones that they like, you know, the dogs and the cats, you know, all those, you know, they got them. So all those pets, they can never want the system to change. The only thing they can support you to do as the people is to support them to remove the part of the system that is stressing them to. As soon as you help them remove their own part that is stressing them, they abandon you to your fate. Immediately, this is the problem of Nigeria. This is the problem with Nigeria. So it's not about, oh, I heard somebody say 2023 is here. What are we doing? Everybody here is expecting salvation in 2023 after you have sat down in your house and done nothing for 20-something years. You are waiting. 2023, you are going to face it. You are joking. In my mind, everybody, all the volunteers who have the MOP, they are working hard day and night. In my own mind, I'm even hoping I'm not ready.